Junior, senior.
G'day YouTubers, it's Senior here from Junior Senior Gaming, and today it's the weekly drive, and voted by you the viewers, we have the Kamaz 5410 plus trailers. And let's see, that got 9 votes. We also had the Concept Black, which looks like a lot of people weren't too happy with that update. So anyway, that got 6 votes, and we also had the Ford Cargo. And that only got 4 votes. So I know that we'd actually seen the Cargo before, but you know, I thought we haven't seen it in a long time, so let's check it out. But it wasn't quite worthy of the weekly drive, so. But this one is. So let's check out where we're off to today. So first of all, we are over here in Kosice, I don't even know if that's the correct name. And then we're off to Lublin. So, yeah, just a little drive there, and we have loaded up today. We have, let's see, Cargo is 3PHO. I don't even know what 3PHO is. Is that like 3PCO? 3CPO? You know that robot thing that in Star Wars, beep, 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 beep sort of thing, you know? No, that's R2-D2. Oh, yeah. Jeez, I'm getting my Star Wars mixed up. Oh, my goodness. One of the guys, if the guys at work watched me, one of them would actually kill me right now. 3CPO. Whatever. This big silver Nimrod thing. Not silver. Bloody gold friggin' Nimrod thing. It looks like a big, giant, erect penis. Made out of gold. Golden penis. There we go. We'll just call him Golden Penis. How about that? Jesus, that took a lot to get out. Anyway, let's get on the road. And let's take this for a spin. Actually, I've got to turn the lights on. There we go. Man, these gears are hard in this. Right, now I'm just going to change back. Oh, there's the GPS over there. I don't need to. And we got traffic too. How nice. Whose idea was it to pick this load up in the middle of the bloody day? You can see it's a little bit slow, this truck, but it's still a lot of fun. No, I want third. There we go. Thank you. And I'm going to jump over in that lane, mate. Right. There we go. So, yeah, look, this is a real challenge to drive in itself because just to get it moving needs a lot of revs, and you got to slowly pull the clutch out. I love the shifter too, how it changes. Come on, baby, we can do this. It's going to take me a bit to get this up to speed, I reckon. There we go. Oh, man. For some reason, the steering wheel's not centered. I don't know why. Hang on. How about if I go like this? There we go. That's a bit better. We're on a hill too, so it's going to be a little bit of a hill start. This is going to be fun. Come on. Come on, you can do it. No, don't go backwards. Come on, it's starting to move. Let the clutch out a bit more. Red signal offence. Oh, well, I'm going through now, fuck it. There we go. I'll jump in that lane too. Wow, this is noisy, this isn't it? Might just turn that volume down a tad. Whoops. Needs to be in fourth. Alright. Nah, that's too low now. There we go. Wow. Okay. Am I just gonna... These guys are slowing down here. Oh, look. They're stopping there for me, so I'm gonna go. Into second. There we go. And third. Alright, come on. There we go. Now we're getting moving. Oh man, this is like such a cool truck to drive. The it's like, it feels so old school. And you know, it's like the truck is really laboring because of the actual load. I mean, so cool. Maybe a little bit more powerful engine in there is what I should have put in there. I only put the standard engine in. There we go. Fourth. Let's see if I can jump in that lane. Get out of this problem here. And I'm going to take a photo. Wow. That was so noisy, isn't it? It's very loud. Right, over here. Not really a great shot there, but anyway. And I'll put some green in and yellow because of the background. A little bit more saturation there. And there we go. Now let's continue on. The sun's not really in the right direction for a good photo there. There we go, fifth. Alright, 90 kilometers per hour we have to do along here. I don't know if we're gonna make it, but anyway. Because this is the top gear, fifth gear. About as good as we're going to get. 70. Man, is it noisy. Anyway, let's get on to the SCS news. So, first of all, I want to talk about the latest blog post. The latest blog post. Now, they were talking about aiming for an open beta next week. That's what they're aiming for, it says in there. I'm not sure. I don't think closed beta has closed yet that I have heard. But I could be wrong. It may have, and I just haven't heard anything about it yet. Hang on. Come on, get in the right damn gear. You can't stop here. Stupid thing. So yeah, I haven't heard about closed beta being finished yet, but Or maybe, oh, I might have, and I just have missed it, so. Come on, baby, you can do it. But anyway, they were saying that it should be, they're aiming for next week, so that will actually be really good if they do, because we'll be having a look at that one as soon as we possibly can. Bit of a handful, this truck. Really cool, actually. I like it. No, I want third. There we go. Now, let's see. They were also talking about liftable trailer axles. Now, what that's going to do is it's going to allow you to distribute your weight a little bit better on the actual trailer, which will then give you better fuel economy. So while you're actually driving, now a lot of people will actually do that, but I think that a lot of people really are not going to bother about it too much because they just go and repair in game, and it's no big deal if you actually have a bit of damage or something. Nobody really worries about it. So far out, that's loud. So yeah. It's going to be good, though. It's going to be good because those people that do want to drive properly, those people that do actually want to run it like a real-life business are going to be able to. And it's that one step forward to a game that is going to be more real, more like a real-life situation, which is great. And that's what you want with simulation. The better it is, the more realistic it is, the better it's going to be. So that's actually going to be really good. Now, one thing that you need to note, and I'd like to thank American Stig for this, who actually pointed this out to me. In the actual picture that is underneath the second picture that's in that blog, there is a line that says lockable diff. Now, does that mean we're going to be getting lockable diffs soon? I don't know. I'd have to say that's a maybe. I'm going to take a photo. I'm going to have to say that's a maybe, and that's a good chance that we will be, because SES are known for letting little things leak out like that every now and then. Just a little sort of hint here and there, just to tease you a bit. And that's what they do. So, I'd say that, yeah, there is a good chance that they will be bringing out that sort of stuff. The lockable diffs. So, can't wait. That's going to really help me because, one, I've had a lot of problem in the past where I've beached the truck because it only had the drive on one side, and the truck got beached. So it was really, really weird. The drive was here on the mod, and then it was there on the rear, and not along the back there, like it should be. So, but anyway, it was beaching me, and I got stuck. Several times that's happened to me. So this will allow me to lock the diff, and allow me to get out of tighter situations in the rough areas. All right, downhill now. So that is good. When the beta comes out, that's one of the first things I'm going to do. Now, check out is if that is in there. It's going to be really good. Now, one other thing as well is that if you want to have those liftable axles on the trailer, you're going to need to assign a key, because SES have said that they have not assigned it to a key because they don't want to mess up with your profile, because there is tons and tons and tons of people out there who have a profile that is set. Parking lot. I don't want to park here. That's dodgy. Why did they do that? That's weird. There is tons of people who actually have a... Shit. Tons of people who have a profile and that they don't want to damage it. So, where's that gear? Come on. Find a gear. There we go, and use it. Just use that one. There we go. Does some reason I couldn't get it into gear. Bloody thing. Yeah, so there we go. There's a little bit of insight there, and thank you very much to Stig for pointing out that to me, that we're looking that they had a lockable diffs. They have said that in the past, but no actual time frame was said when they're actually going to put that in. So interesting. Right, fifth gear, there we go. 70 along here. Try and do 70. Now, that's it for SES news. Now, for those of you who are in the actual, who are in the official Junior Senior Gaming Convoy group, you need to head on over to the Junior Senior Gaming Forum and check it out, because this week's convoy, which will be on Sunday, is actually now available for you to see. So you can actually see all the details and stuff like that. If you are not in the convoy group, then you can apply. Jesus, track IR, stop it. You can apply for the actual convoy to join in. So, and the way to do that is to head on over to the Junior Senior Gaming Forum, sign up to the forum, and then up the very top is apply for convoy group. So you'll need to apply for it there. So make sure you do so. And then I'll be having a look at applications. I'll try to do it on the Saturday if I can. And so that people know that they're actually been accepted. Alright, so yeah, make sure you head on over to the forum if you're in the convoy group to check out where we're off to this weekend. And that will be on Sunday at our normal time. And if you wish to watch it, we will be streaming not only on Beam, but we will be streaming on YouTube as well at the same time. Track IR, I tell you what, you're driving me nuts. You really are. Driving me insane. I've been shifting my light around. I know which light it is. It's this one over this side here. And I've been shifting it around all over the place, but nothing seems to help. It just messes up with the track IR all the time. As soon as I turn it off, it's perfectly fine. But I got light, dark on one side, light on one side and dark on the other, and it looks funny. I know I'm staying in this lane. Next bit of information, guys. The Sivnovka map that we used last month on the Farming Simulator server is now available for you to, if you want to download it and play around with it yourself, you can do so. It's on the forum, so head over to the Junior Senior Gaming Forum, and underneath the Farming Simulator section, you'll see a post in there about our last month's map. I might do that from now on when we actually have a map. I might allow you guys to download it so that you can continue on the map if you wish. Yeah, so there we go. So it doesn't matter about the mods that we used in there, because the mods we were using weren't really that great. So we were basically just using the standard stuff, except for a couple of mods. And the ones that we were using, we didn't really use much anyway, because we didn't like them too much. So I didn't bother about the mods, posting them on there. But the map you can still use. And it's just a matter of going to your, grabbing that zip file that I've got there, and taking that to the Farming Simulator directory under My Games. Oops. Come on, get in there. Under My Games, and then in there you'll see a Farming Simulator directory, Farming Simulator 17. You just create a folder in there called Save Game, and then whatever save game you want it to be. Come on, get in the right gear. And then you'll go into game and then activate it through there in game. It should show up as that save game, so should relatively be easy. But if you have any problems, just on the forum, just address the issues on the forum and we'll be able to help you there. Speed camera. Yeah, so that's the Subnovska map. Now, another thing, guys, we have a competition going this week where if you actually go to Beam, because we're actually new to Beam now, and we're trying to get a whole heap of people over there because, one, it is a lot better. It's a lot better experience than Twitch was. One, you've got... you can use a whole heap of sound effects and stuff like that so that you can interact with me. There's other options for interaction, but I haven't actually activated them yet. I'm still working out a few other bugs first, and then we'll start looking at that. But there's other things like that you can do, like, you know, control the game and stuff like that, and, you know... you know, there's heaps and heaps and heaps of things that you can actually do, but I haven't got into that quite yet. I will though in the eventually. Also, there is the picture itself is a lot clearer, and there's very much next to no delay. It's very little delay from what you get. At first we had a few bugs and a few problems, but that's always the case when you get a new platform. You know, there's always some kind of bugs and glitches, but the guys at Beam have actually been really good and they've worked it out for me, and we're actually now streaming very clear and very fast, so that's really good. I'm very impressed with them. To be honest, it is actually streaming faster than what YouTube is, so that is definitely really good. Definitely really good. Now, Beam is only a very small and young platform. Has only been out for around about a year. But I'll let you know that it has been taken over by Microsoft. So Microsoft, in all of their wisdom, will either do one of two things. Smash it or make it big. So either way. So that's generally what Microsoft do. So from what I've read... they're actually looking at incorporating it into Windows 10. If they do that, then that is going to be... Beam is going to be the next big thing, I reckon. So, it'll be bigger than Twitch. And Microsoft will make it bigger than Twitch. And they'll make it... may even be bigger than YouTube. So, we just have to wait and see, guys, at what happens there. But I really do encourage you to go over there this week and... follow Junior Senior Gaming, because the competition we have this week is you can win a t-shirt, a free t-shirt, Junior Senior Gaming t-shirt, and a hat. Now, it's not the hat that I've got here, it's the white one with the logo, so it's still a good hat for you to walk around with, you know, and wear. So, and we'll post that out to you free as well, so you don't have to worry about paying for postage. We'll pay for that postage as well to get it to you. So there we go, guys. Pretty good competition, I think, if you're a Junior Senior Gaming fan. And especially if you're a young fella who can't really afford to go to the shop and buy anything from our shop. I know there's a lot of people out there who say, well, you know, Senior, I can't really afford to buy any of the t-shirts there. Because of postage, or because of, you know, I don't have any money or anything like that or whatever. Well, that's why we're doing this competition, because for those fans who really want to get some Junior Senior merchandise but can't afford it because they don't have the money or whatever, now's your chance. Get in there, get that, you know, sign up to Beam, follow us on Beam, and we'll draw that at the end of the week. Okay, so make sure you get in there, guys, and give it a go, because it's definitely a worthwhile competition, especially since you don't have to pay for anything. Cost you nothing. Wow. I think that's pretty good. Anyway, let's see, whereabouts on the map are we? It's taken us a while to get there. Holy moly. Oh, we're almost there. Sorry, I thought we were going the other way. We're almost there, so. I thought for a second there that we were going the other way and that we'd only just started. Man, I would have had a few choice words then. What else? Let's see. I've started doing some flight simulator. Oh, sorry. X-Plane 11. Now, the beta for X-Plane is actually out. And I have been testing the full version of that beta. I purchased the full version of X-Plane 11, which came with X-Plane 10. And I also have been using the beta. So to learn how to fly, so very interesting. You can check out the very first learning to fly episode, which I did live, and see how I actually did. I don't think I did too bad. You know, I was very surprised at how I went on that that actual stream. I was thinking it was going to be more problems than what there were, but anyway, it was still good. Press the following to stop the engine. Why? I don't want to stop the engine. There we go. Yeah, we'll do some more fly X-Plane 11 in the future, because I really did have fun learning how to fly, and I didn't just fly a one type of plane. I flew a couple of types of planes, and it was really cool. It really was. All right, looks like here we are. Come on, get into third. I think if I was to drive this again, I would just give it a bit bigger engine. And I would change the gearbox. I'm not a fan of this gearbox. But anyway. There we go, we stopped pretty good. But overall, this truck is actually really good truck to drive. It feels like an old school truck, and if you're an old school fan and you love the older trucks, then this is one you must try. I really do implore that you try this truck. Especially if you don't give it the really high power engine, go for something maybe a little bit more than this, the one that I've got now. Which was the 275, I think it was. Maybe go something for around about the 350 or the 400 to get that little bit of oomph. But the lower you have the engine, the actual more it feels like, you know, you're actually really driving an old truck. Oh, we can test the wipers. Oh yeah, they're working. And here we go, our destination. One thing I didn't check out, which was the trailer. The wheels are spinning there, so that's good. Let's just have a look at something. Yeah, the front's dragging. You can see it dragging. But that was to be expected because there's no articulation points. Oh, I stalled it. That's the only way to work that out with that, to, you know, do it that way. Come on. Wow. Wow, this does not have the balls, this this engine. Oh, looks like this is going to be a stall fest. Oh, come on. I got the clutch half out at the moment, just trying to get it into the right sort of, you know, angle. To get it going, and then I'm trying to get this in the right angle as well. I messed that up. Hang on, I'll have to just turn that a bit sharper. That first gear. That first gear is a bit of a tricky gear. Oh, a bit of a storm now. We are actually meant to have storms around here this week, but no, nothing. The weather people got no idea, I think. All right, there we go. Oh man, all that stuff's getting wet. I hope that's potatoes in there and it's nothing else. Drop the trailer, there we go. Wow, that's actually really good. I am very impressed with this truck. I really do like how far it's come along. I really do. Definitely a must try, guys, especially if you like old trucks. Definitely. Well, there we go. That is this week's weekly drive. I hope you enjoyed driving coming along with me to drive this truck. I had a lot of fun, and definitely I think you should give it a go, guys. But that is the Kamaz 5410. And yeah, that was the trailers that come with it as well. So it's 5410 plus trailers. It's very good. The link will be in the description, guys. You can grab it. We didn't use any map mods or anything this week, but another time we'll use some other map mods and see where we can go there. But anyway, guys, that is pretty much it for me. If this is the first time you've seen Junior Senior Gaming, then make sure you head on over to our Junior Senior Gaming channel and check it out on YouTube. There is over 1,600 videos for you to watch. Plenty to keep you entertained. There's not just American Truck Simulator or Euro Truck Simulator, but there's also Forza Horizon, there's, as I said, X-Plane 11's on there. There's heaps of stuff, guys, so make sure you check it out. Until next time, keep the shiny side up and the greasy side down, and I'm 1010 on the side. And remember, game on! Thanks for watching, YouTubers. If you'd like to watch some more trucking good videos, then click on the links beside. If you'd like to visit our website, or you'd also like to subscribe, then click on the links below. Thanks again for watching, YouTubers, and remember, game on!